I just want to know then, at what stage did Andrea think it was a good idea to join Neil at the top of the Rovers?
I don't think she really thought it through properly, mm-hmm. Eamon. She climbs the ladder hoping she can just persuade him down. And then she's almost there and she reaches a hand up and he slips. And that's it. Disaster strikes.
Well, don't tell us everything, because then we get people saying, spoiler.
I know.
But it's been very interesting watching this story. I think he's brilliant, William Travis, I have to say.
Brilliant
actor. Stalkery husband, isn't he?
Yeah.
And we had Craig Charles here last week, or the week before, where he said, you know, as the viewer and Craig's character, you start feeling sorry for him. We feel a bit sorry for him, although he's being very creepy and following you around.
I know.
You know, you feel for him, don't you? His wife's gone, he still loves you.
I think by tonight, you might think opposite about him.
Okay.
Because he has he's taking stalking to another level. He really does love Andrea, really is besotted with her. But it does get a bit creepy tonight.
But it would just be better for everyone all round if he just fell off the roof. wouldn't it? I mean, without being cruel, it would. But life would be happy then, really.
Well, she does feel sorry for him. I mean, you know, you'll see tonight, I won't give too much away, but there is a sad side to what happens. Yeah. It all explodes this evening, and I've filmed this ages ago, and I'm so excited about it.
You were never up that roof.
I was.
You still weren't.
Eamon, I did it all, honestly.
Yeah, so how much is you and how much is stunt person?
We had two really amazing stunt doubles who were stood by, and I basically said, I want to do it all myself.
So we can see
like
you. I think this is you getting harnessed up.
Yeah.
And now you're beginning to feel... Yeah, it was the wrong thing. Just, look, right.
It was so high up. Yeah. And there's my lovely stunt lady. She was fantastic. And I think, hopefully, they've used one bit of her that was quite frightening that I couldn't really do myself. And I think the rest is me.
So when you get up there, and, I mean, you've done high things before.
Yeah, we've done some high.
I
was on the wires,
So does it, I mean, are you immune to all of that, or does it still take your breath away?
Well, on Dancing on Ice, you've got two wires.
Yes.
And on this, I only had one, and it was attached from my stomach here, so you have to put all your trust in one wire. But the people who were doing the wires and everything were absolutely fantastic.
Did you get the wobbly knees?
I did get the shakes when I was at the top for the first time. I did get scared. But actually, being on the roof, Will's job was actually harder than my job.
Is that him?
Lane. That was frightening.
No, I wouldn't like that. No. I mean, and our praise goes out to all roofers out there who actually have to go and do that job.
Or without a wire.
Without a wire.
Builders who build chimneys and various things like that.
Are you loving being in Corrie? You seem very excited about it still.
I absolutely love it. I feel so lucky. It's such an amazing place to work. The people are fantastic. The building we've now got, the new building, the new set, it's just extraordinary.
And I've heard, little birds told me that they've extended your contract. Yeah. So that means Andrea's staying around for a bit longer.
I am there for another year.
Well, now we know she doesn't fall off the roof and die now.
No, we knew that. You said let's keep it all secret tonight,
and then you say she's there for another year.
She doesn't.
Well, they're not going to be in a coffin for a year, is she?
Don't argue. Honestly, it's fine. Don't row. I don't die. That's
you don't,
the best
right.
Yeah.
She doesn't die.
Uh-huh.
She can't die because she's going to be in the netball team.
Uh-huh.
I am in the netball team.
Yeah, so Corrie have got their own netball team.
Corrie have got a netball team. We are doing a match on the 22nd November in aid of Tech Santa, and we are playing opposite Emmerdale. So my bottom is in agony as I sit here right now because I've been practicing and training all week.
What's netball got to do with your bottom?
Oh, it's
what, you fall a lot?
You should try netball. What? It works every muscle.
It's all that stop-start thing, isn't it?
Yeah,
when was
brilliant.
The last time you played netball then?
When I was 10.
Oh. Yeah, like most of us.
Don't mention how many years ago that was.
Who's in the Corrie team?
Oh, we've got quite a few of us. Yeah. There's Katie Kavanagh, there's Tisha Merry, I think Sammy is doing it, there's me. Yeah, there's a whole group of us, cast and crew.
Yeah.
And we're aiming to win and beat Emmerdale again this year.
So how good are you? Should they be worried?
I'm goal shooter.
Oh,
that means I've got to get them in the net. Yeah.
That's the important bit.
It's all right. I'll do all right.
Now, Anthony Cotton, who plays Sean Tully, of course, has been tweeting about a new interest for him, who turns out to be a vicar. And a very good friend of yours by the name of?
Dan Brocklebank.
Now, Dan, we know Dan from Emmerdale?
Yes, he's in Emmerdale with me. We've been best friends for 10 years. And he had an audition 2 weeks ago, and I couldn't believe he'd even got an audition. So I went with him and I sat in
Why, because he's a bit rubbish?
We've been wanting to work together for so long, and it just came up and he went, I can't believe I've got an audition. So I went with him for the audition, I sat waiting for him, and it went really well, and then he got the phone call.
There
Unbelievable. can't believe it.
So he's going to be love interest for Sean.
Yeah, for so Anthony and him have got a really good storyline coming up. Which
now, have you got rid of your spiders? Because I saw you tweet a picture of the spider that infested your balcony.
It was hilarious.
A family of them.
I found one spider. Oh.
It's not that big, Hayley.
Right. Oh, don't be ridiculous.
It's not that big. That is massive.
What are you talking about?
It's massive. Oh, it was so big. But it was on the bridge at Media City, so nowhere near Corrie or anything. Yeah. But, you know, it all broke loose when I got to work. Everyone was like, are we infested with spiders? I was like, no.
That is not a spider. That is some sort of...
massive.
That is massive. That is absolutely
Look at that.
Massive.
You can't set the roof. That's scary.
We were like 200
Did you call
times
the fire brigade or anything?
That's why I stopped. I was walking across the bridge. I had to stop to take a picture of it because it was that big. Mm. But there is a lot of spiders around.
I know, I just want to say to people, are there more than usual this year? And they're bigger. I think they're... mutant spiders. I do think they're mutant. I think they've come out of the drains like Ninja Turtles. I do, and I think they're now taking over
the world.
The earth. I do.
I hear like squeals from upstairs. I come and go, oh my God, you see the size of this? It's like that big.
But I can assure you that we're not infested with
spiders. They're not infested at Coronation Street, no.
Well, do you know, you laugh at that and you say that, and you, Ruth woke up during the night, in the middle of the week, gasping because her breath had been taken away, because the only weapon of defence that I could find was deodorant in the bathroom.
I woke up to find him standing on a chair spraying deodorant around the room trying to kill a spider.
Oh, but we need the spiders. You have to you have to save them. We need
Believe
them.
Me, you don't need them when you're lying in bed at night and they're crawling over your face.
No, all right, let's not talk about that.
You don't need that.
No, we don't need them.
Anyway, it's great to see you. Looking forward to seeing the whole Andrea Lloyd Neil story. Coronation Street tonight, 7:30, of course. Good to see you, Hayley.
Thank you.
Thank you.